All right, guys, we are hanging out here with 3 Days Grace, and who do I have here?
Brad.
Brad?
And Neil.
And what do you guys do in the band?
I play bass.
Plays bass?
Drums.
You guys have a brand new album, Life Starts Now. Tell me about it.
Life Starts Now came out in September. It's our third album. We recorded it in Vancouver, BC. I think it's our best album yet. You know, it's very personal and some pretty heavy messages on there, and we're pretty proud of it.
How do you think your new album stands out from some of your previous work?
The biggest thing is that we wanted the record to sound like we actually sound live, you know, because there's so many bands out there that use, like, you know, backing tracks and all this crap to try to fill in their sound, and we're just, like, pretty anti that. You know, we like to keep it real and stay true to ourselves.
It seems like you guys enjoy touring with Breaking Benjamin.
Yeah, you know, we're actually really good friends with them, and I think we share a lot of the same fans. And, you know, when we're putting a tour together, it's like I was saying before, it's important for us to bring out bands that can actually get up on stage and deliver live and take pride in their show and stuff, and which is like sadly few and far between these days, you know.
What kind of crazy, you've got to have at least one crazy story from all your tours with Breaking Benjamin and, you know, all these other great bands. What's one of the crazy stories you guys have had?
Well, we've had Hinder out with us a few times.
Yep.
And they make a point of trying to do stuff.
Lighting their ball sack on fire.
Stapling
their ball sack to somebody's ass. Shitting in each other's boots.
And then playing
in. I don't know, I could go on and on. Basically, they want us to talk about it. So.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. I think it was called the Hepatitis B Tour 2007. I think that's what they officially had called their thing.
You ever have any crazy fan moments or people who are just really excited to see you?
Oh, yeah, there's crazy people everywhere in this world. That's the other thing that I'd tell a young band.
3 Days Grace. There's crazy people.
I tell myself, if I was telling myself at 17, like, watch out for all the freaks. But, you know, everybody's all right. There's just a lot of people that, I don't know, want to make a name for themselves in whatever capacity possible. Like, I've seen guys, like, you know, I'll be sitting there, Adam will be playing an acoustic song live, we'll be playing in front of, you know, an arena full of people, and this happened one time. I looked and there's this guy crouching back behind my drum riser. So my first instinct was he's gonna go and attack Adam or whatever. So we jumped on him first and basically immobilized him, like, just stuff like that. You never quite know. And I mean, you know, all jokes aside, like, look at a guy like Dimebag Darrell, like, Jesus, like, you know, you just have to fucking, I don't know, man, you gotta look over your shoulder at all times.
So would you say that because you're famous, you have a little bit of, you feel sometimes a little less safe than the average person?
I don't know about that. I just think, people gravitate towards something that makes them feel important. So if that means that they can be around something that makes them feel like they are, you know, in existence, that's what they do. So at any cost.
Let's see. Hey, what's up? All right. So if I wanted to join 3 Days Grace, what would you guys need me to do?
Fired. Yeah.
Fired.
Yeah. You've just been fired before. That's how it's not going to happen.
Oh, it's not going to happen?
It's not going to happen. Well, you were just in the band for about a second. Adam just walked out and fired you.
Oh, yeah. Because so there were four of us.
Up.
Yeah.
You just wrap this up. Fucking get your shit together and fuck out.
Ouch. I thought we were going to be a band
joking.
Together.
I'm half joking.
Half joking. So what do you think 3 Days Grace, back when you got started, would be surprised to know about 3 Days Grace here in 2010?
I think it's what we would tell other bands in our shoes that maybe are making the mistake of thinking that there's any sort of shortcut. I think that's the biggest thing, and I think you know, shows like American Idol and all this stuff, and even like YouTube sensations and all that crap put into people's heads as musicians that there's some fast track to the top or whatever, and that's completely not true. If you want to do it for real and do it with a sense of pride, it really it's really building it from the ground up. And even on a tour level, we even still have that philosophy at this level that, you know, we have to be coming back to Grand Island, Nebraska, four, five, six times. It's like, you know, Omaha, like all these places. you got to keep coming back, because that builds a real fan base, because we just believe that if you can go up on stage and kill it in front of people, people walk away saying, wow, those guys can really play and it was a whole great experience, then that's how you build the fan base that's never going to go away. Been in the band already for the last 15 years. Oh, okay. Just a second. Our ice is here.
We've got to
stop this interview.
Pause real quick.
We got some ice on the way in here. Total emergency. Can you get the cubed ice in here immediately, please?
Stop the interview.
We got some ice. Hold on, guys. Do I get some ice?
Sure. Yeah, you guys can. You guys can take all the ice you want.
All right.
Yeah.
That's how you get in 3 days grace. You got to get the ice ready.
Be the guy who brings the ice, right?
The beer cold first, right? So.
All the cubes of ice that are about to come in a barrel.
Okay.
Then we'll consider.
You know, I bet I could find someone to do that for me for like an autograph or something.
So, okay.
Yeah. All right. I shouldn't have told you that. I heard you guys. You had like a collector's edition, and like you smashed a bunch of guitars. What's the story behind that? Because I've never heard anything like that before.
Well, we were shooting the video for Break, and we decided, we just get a whole bunch of guitars and smash the shit out of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then
thought it'd be a good idea.
Yeah, we thought it was a great idea. We thought it was intellectual genius.
I can see that.
Yeah. No, it turns out that we got a call from the lawyer a few days before saying we had to smooth the edges on the jagged pieces just because of the liability of someone like buying a deluxe set. And you know, like you or I, the first thing I want to do when I open up a deluxe set of someone's record is grab a jagged piece and jam it into my eye.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? So we had to smooth it down just to prevent that from happening.
The lawyer was concerned that if you put sharp objects in a CD that they would hurt themselves.
That's what people do.
Lawsuit. Yeah,
it's like one of those things where, you know, you pull out that sack out of a new pair of shoes that says do not eat.
And then you...
Because I know that that's my number one thing.
Yeah, that's what
if
I think.
If I buy something and I pull it out and there's something in my shoe, I'm going to fucking eat that shit.
Don't worry, there's plenty more where that came from. Come with me behind the scenes, backstage, and onto the tour bus to meet your favorite stars. We are backstage with Slipknot. I am here with my good friend, the American Idol, Chris Allen. I'll ask questions you've never heard before and show you the answers you won't find anywhere else. You said you're a Justin Timberlake fan.
No.
No?
No.
Maybe that wasn't you?
What do you like about Katy Perry?
Everything.
Happy birthday, dear Brian.
Huge meaning or self-defining sort of thing.
I think we just lost one of our interviews. Rate, comment, and subscribe for new videos every week. Reporting for YouTube, I'm Brian Odell. I'm the reason you go on tour.
You're the reason I'm here, baby.